Hi guys, Matt from Haltech here, and today we're going to look at this little control box here. It's the Haltech Direct Current Motor Controller Driver, or DCMD for short. So, what is the DCMD? Well, as the name suggests, it's a direct current motor driver, or in nerd speak, it's a dual half-bridge DC motor driver capable of 8 amps continuous current draw or 30 amps of burst current per channel. Primarily, the DCMD has been designed to allow devices like these Turbosmart Electric Wastegates to be controlled directly from any Elite or Nexus series engine management system. Now, the thing about these gates is they require quite a lot of current draw to drive the motor correctly, and the Elite series ECUs were never designed to supply such high current loads, so a device like this DCMD is used between the ECU and the gate to handle the high current loads required by the electronic motor inside the gate. On a Nexus ECU, you can run an E-gate directly from the ECU if you've got enough high current outputs available still. If you've used up all your high current outputs on your Nexus, then you can still use the DCMD with any available low current outputs, just like an Elite Series ECU. So, let's take a look at how we'd wire up and set up the Turbosmart E-gate using the DCMD, then we'll take a look at a couple other uses for this nifty little driver. So, the first thing you notice is the wiring connection on the DCMD. There's two Deutsch DT series connectors on the wire harness, a 2-pin version and a 4-pin version. So the 2-pin plug contains the motor drive wires. These two wires connect directly into the electronic wastegate motor, and they're there to actually move the motor up and down. On the 4-pin plug, there's a power wire in pin location number 1. This needs to be wired into your fuse or relay block, and it needs to be connected to a switched 12-volt power supply that's capable of providing at least 8 amps of continuous current. Pin 2 is a ground, and again, this ground needs to be able to sink at least 8 amps worth of current, so you need to ensure a good solid contact to ground. And pins 3 and 4 are the control wires that go back to the Haltech Elite or Nexus series ECU. Now, any unused DPO, ignition output, inject output, stepper motor output, or drive-by-wire control output can be used as a control wire for the DCMD. So built into the wastegate, there's both a temperature sensor and a position sensor. Both of these sensors need to be wired into the ECU for the electronic wastegate function that's available in Haltech NSP software to work correctly. So let's just open up NSP and we'll take a look at how we'd set up the ECU side of things for a moment. Now obviously the Turbosmart electronic wastegate is used for boost control, so we navigate our way to the boost control function in NSP and we scroll down to the wiring node. In the output type, we want to change it from one solenoid to the specific Turbosmart E-gate that you have, and if you have one or two gates under control. The wastegate drive type in this case is going to be the DCMD. Note that if you have a Haltech Nexus series ECU, you could run the gate directly from your ECU if you have any output wires that are compatible available. On the Elite series ECU, you'll always need to use the DCMD motor driver. And that's exactly what we're going to do here, so that's what I'm going to select. I'll select two available outputs from the ECU to connect into the DCMD. These are the two drive control wires on the 4-pin Deutsch DT connector that we spoke about earlier. The active state needs to be set to low on both outputs for the DCMD. So select available inputs in the position sensor and the temperature sensor, and you're all set up and you're ready to start using your Turbosmart electronic wastegate on Elite Series or Nexus Series ECU. Well, almost. You first have to calibrate it. So the calibration procedure is really simple. You simply hit calibrate button, you'll hear the gate go up and down, and then it'll be finished in about 25 seconds or so. Now we're ready for boost control. So that's how we use the DCMD on a Turbosmart E-gate. But there are some other uses. The DCMD is essentially just a high current switching device, and it can be used to control any DC motor in or out. Better still, it can be used to accurately control any device with up to 8 amps of continuous current draw. So one example of this might be boosting the output of a drive-by-wire throttle control system. So it's not uncommon to see setups like this one, which is an RB26 manifold that was originally cable setup, but with the help of a nifty little bracket and BMW M3 throttle and a bit of trickery there, you can convert this thing to an electronic throttle setup. Now this setup looks amazing and it does indeed perform really, really well, but the system itself has some limitations because all of these linkages can get some drag in them. This drag means the inbuilt electronic throttle control chip inside the Elite 2500 ECU has to work a lot harder to maintain control of the throttle's position. This causes a buildup of heat inside the throttle control chip itself, and in some circumstances, it can actually cause the chip inside the ECU to overheat. Now, of course, one way to fix all of these issues is to resolve the mechanical drag on the throttle shaft or the linkages, but sometimes that's just not an option, in which circumstance something like the DCMD can be used to increase the current supply to the drive-by-wire throttle motor and pack that little bit of extra punch for you. So there are indeed a whole host of other potential uses for the DCMD outside of just DC motor control. It can be used for switching of any high-speed device that fits within the 8 amp current rating of the pins. So you could use it to run relatively low current pumps like the Nissan Atessa pump, or a low current variable speed water injection system, or a variable fan or something like that. Even one of those variable exhaust flaps. I can see the DCMD being used for active aero. So you're going down the straight, turn on a little motor, can move your aero up and down. What you do with this little guy here is really limited only by your imagination. Now that's all we've got time for in today's product overview of the Haltech DCMD. For more information on this product and all of our products, visit our website, www.haltech.com. Follow along on all of our usual social media channels. And of course, don't forget to ring the bell right here on YouTube. Well, I'm Matt from Haltech, and I'll see you next time.